Who said? Hello? Can you hear me? Bethany. Connie. Please stop crying, Mommy. Thank you.
Shit! It's me! Get in here! Thank God! What the hell is this?
Pleased to see you too, Kate. Glad you're alive.
Have you seen Mark?
No. I've seen Demet, though. He's creeping around.
What is all of this?
He's got video feeds, recording decks, a mixer big enough for countless mics.
He's watching everything.
It's more than that. He's got utilities running through here, hydraulics, electrics, everything. He can control the whole building from here.
How far down does it go?
This all connects. This is how he's getting around the house. Charlie would say this guy is a fractured segment, that he's wearing a mask to...
Take a look at this. What is that?
The guy we saw murdered.
It was a setup?
There was no groundskeeper.
We saw a guy in a yellow jacket with our stuff.
I guess that was Mr. Demet.
I think it's a mistake to say he's just crazy. He is in full control of what he's doing. He's just not wired like the rest of us.
That's not crazy.
He's been tracking us since we arrived. Crazy implies out of control. Look at this place. This is methodical. That's not crazy.
Chicago Police! Mr. Monday, this is Chicago Police. Can you open the door, please? Mr. Monday, I'm Officer Stanley with Chicago Police Department. Can you hear me, sir? Agent Monday. Fuck. Fuck. Oh. Dispatch, this is Officer Stanley. I need assistance at 8 West 50th Street, requesting immediate backup. I'm in Agent Monday's apartment. There's blood everywhere and a body. I need immediate support. I think... Oh.
Thank you.
But he's wearing the mask as part of the performance. At best, maybe he's insecure about something and it gives him confidence.
Insecure? Like, low self-esteem? Is he uncomfortable at parties? Did his mommy not hug him enough?
Bad parenting can definitely be a factor, but it could be a shitty dad just as much, or an uncle, any adult figure, really. Over here!
Look at this. It's all his little tricks of moving walls and crap.
Nothing in this shit box is real. He controls everything from here. It's a murder factory.
You're right. We should use this against him.
All right. What's your plan?
Okay, look. He's in here, right? So we get him to go down this hall, and we trap him between these two moving walls. There's no other way out of there. He'd be stuck.
Okay. But how do you make sure he goes down that hall to begin with? One of us is going to have
to be bait.
No. No way. It's too risky, Jamie.
So is letting him run free. I'd say that's more dangerous. Come on.
There's no second chances here.
It's my plan. I'll be the bait.
If you're sure, just... If it looks like it's going south, get the hell out of there.
No argument here. I'm gonna hang on to it. I'm more likely to need it. Okay. That's enough of a moment. Let's do this.
Stick to the plan.
Obviously.
So how do we get out?
Third floor must be a work in progress. Okay, be ready. You're gonna have to time it right to trap him and not me. All right. Here goes nothing. Head down the hall, keep to the right. But more rooms being built. Huh. Jamie, fucking run!
Shit.
Oh, God. What is it?
A button. There's a reverse symbol on it.
What does it?
Shit. No!
Excruciating way to go. Jamie pressed the button to kill Kate. I know they didn't always see eye to eye, but I didn't think she'd be that cold-blooded. Jamie chose not to save Erin when she could, leaving her to die, deprived of oxygen, suffocating to death. Perhaps you regret not taking me up on the offer of a hint earlier. Would you like one now? Let's see if Sir Arthur can help us. This is from The Man with the Twisted Lip. Have you read it? You should. A trusty comrade is always of use. And a chronicler, still more so. I think that last bit might refer to me. You should get back. I hope these chats are helpful. I certainly wouldn't want them to be intimidating. I'll be watching your progress, as always, watching very closely.